good morning, and welcome to this, our Holy Mass celebration for the third Sunday after Easter. I'm Father Michael Schamp, pastor and bishop of the Old Catholic Church of Antioch in Tucson. We begin with our opening song, I Sing the Mighty Power of God. I sing the mighty power of God that made the mountains rise, that spread the flowing seas abroad and built the lofty skies. I sing the wisdom that ordained the sun to rule the day. The moon shines full at his command and all the stars obey. I sing the goodness of the Lord that filled the earth with food. He formed the creatures with his word and then pronounced them good. Lord, how thy wonders are displayed where'er I turn my eye. If I survey the ground I tread or gaze upon the sky, there's not a plant or flower below but makes the glories known, and clouds arise and tempests blow by order from thy throne. While all that borrows life from thee is ever in thy care, and everywhere that I can be, the God are present there. Let us begin with our entrance antiphon, today taken from Psalm 33. Let all the earth cry out to God with joy. Let the praise of his name proclaim his glorious praise. Hallelujah. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. We begin as we always do, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The love of our Lord Jesus Christ, the grace of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In order to celebrate our sacred mystery today, let us first call to mind our sins. Lord Jesus, you have shown us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you have given us the consolation of the truth. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the good shepherd leading us into everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. In Adam's sin, the gates of heaven were closed. We were made one with God and heirs to the kingdom of heaven in our baptism. We are thankful for our redemption. May Almighty God forgive you your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. We now begin the liturgy of the Word. Let us pray in confidence, with peace and Easter hope. Father in heaven, author of all truth, a people once in darkness has listened to your word and followed your Son as he rose from the tomb. Hear the prayer of this newborn people and strengthen your church to answer your call. May we rise and come forth into the light of day to stand in your presence until eternity dawns. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our first reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Luke's writing recounts Peter blaming the Jewish people for killing our Lord Jesus Christ, but then adding that judging others should be left to God. Ignorance of those who should know better is blameworthy, causing harm and disaster. We must guard against being a danger to ourselves and to others in what we think, say, and do. Hear now these words from the Acts. Peter said to the people, "The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the God of our fathers, has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and denied in Pilate's presence when he had decided to release him. You denied the Holy and Righteous One, and you asked that a murderer be released to you. You put to death the author of life, but God raised him from the dead. Of this we are witnesses. And by faith is his name, this man whom you see and know, his name had made strong. And the faith that comes through it has given him the perfect health in the presence of all of you. Now I know, brothers, that you acted out of ignorance, just as your leaders did. But God has thus brought to fulfillment what he had announced beforehand through the mouth of all the prophets, that his Christ would suffer. Repent, therefore, and be converted, that your sins may be wiped away, and that the Lord may grant you times of refreshment and send you the Messiah, already appointed for you, Jesus, whom heaven must receive until the times of universal restoration, of which God spoke through the mouths of his holy prophets from of old. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Our response today is from Psalm 4. Lord, let your face shine upon us. Join me. Lord, let your face shine upon us. When I call, answer me, O my just God. You who relieve me when I am in distress, have pity on me and hear my prayer. Lord, let your face shine upon us. Know that the Lord does wonders for his faithful one. The Lord will hear me when I call upon him. Lord, let your face shine upon us. O Lord, let the light of your countenance shine upon us. You put gladness into my heart. Lord, let your face shine upon us. As soon as I lie down, I fall peacefully to sleep. For you alone, O Lord, bring security to my dwelling. Lord, let your face shine upon us. Our second reading today is from the first letter of John. John states that knowing God is a religious experience in which we must be involved. Love has very much to do with all of it. This kind of knowledge is acquired not only by prayerful study and introspection, but we must now hear the words from 1 John. My children, I am writing this to you so that you may not commit sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous one. He is the expiation for our sins, and not for our sins only, but for those of the whole world. The way we may be sure that we know him is to keep his commandments. Those who say, I know him, but do not keep his commandments are liars, and the truth is not in them. But whoever keeps his word, the love of God is truly perfected in them. This, too, is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Let us now prepare for the reading of the gospel. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Join me. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Lord Jesus, open the scriptures to us. Make our hearts burn while you speak to us. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Lord, be in my heart and on my lips, and I may worthily proclaim your holy gospel. The Lord be with you. A reading of the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Glory to you, Lord. Cleopas and the other disciple recounted what had taken place on the way to Emmaus and how Jesus was made known to them in the breaking of the bread. While they were still speaking about this, he stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." But they were startled and terrified and thought they were seeing a ghost. But then he said, "Why are you troubled? And why do questions arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet. And know that it is I, myself. Touch me and see me, because a ghost does not have flesh and bones, as you see I have." And as he said this, he showed them his hands and feet. While they were still incredulous for joy and were amazed, he asked them, "Have you anything to eat?" They gave him a piece of baked fish. He took it and ate it in front of them. He said to them, "These are my words, that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses and in the prophets and Psalms must be fulfilled. Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, Thus it is written that the Christ would suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance for the forgiveness of sins would be preached in his name to all nations. Beginning in Jerusalem, you are witnesses of these things. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. And he opened the scriptures to them. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. In a meager way, that is what our homilies are all about when we give them every Sunday or every time we attend Mass where there is a homily. And the role of the priest in the sacrament of the holy sacrifice of the Mass is to bring some light and application of the Word of God into our lives. For me, it's a matter of contemplation of the significance of the words that I read in Holy Scripture and my particular take on how they apply to me as an individual and therefore to everyone. In our particular story today, Luke gives us only a smattering of a description of the walk on the Emmaus Road, but this was quite a landmark journey for the two apostles that took it. They were lamenting and sad because Jesus was taken from them, and they were walking the short distance to the city of Emmaus. And while they were on their way, a stranger joined them in their walk, and while he did so, he spoke to them about the application of the scriptures of the Old and the New Testament, which became the readings that we have in our gospel in the New Testament and also in our epistles that we read during the Masses. But while he was exposing them to the wonders of the revelations that occurred in Scripture, he opened their minds to the glory which was his life and his Messiahhood. And then when he joined them at table later after they reached Emmaus, he broke the bread, gave it to them, and instantly they knew that this was Jesus, the risen Christ. At that point, they ran back and joined their fellows in the upper room, who were huddled still and concerned about their safety, for the sting of the crucifixion was still in their minds. When we read Holy Scripture, particularly when we listen to it at Mass, or we take the opportunity to read the Gospels, or read the Epistles, or even read the Old Testament, we should be conscious of the fact that we are reading words that were put down by extremely sincere individuals. They received their inspiration, we believe, from God himself. They did not lose their individual ability to write or their interpretation of the things that they decided to write about. And so the styles of all the readings and all the gospel selections are different based upon the proclivities of the individual authors. Now, we say that these words are inspired in that we believe that people who write the scriptures or who wrote the scriptures were indeed writing not only from their own experience, but because they had an intuition as to the meaning of those things that they wrote. And so when you listen to the scriptures being read in Holy Mass, or when you take the opportunity to read it yourself, remember that you're not only just reading a chronology, a history, but you are reading the interpretation that comes from the inspiration that these sacred authors used to write these words down. Those who mistakenly believe that the Bible is in fact a history book will be sorely distressed when they find out that there are some contradictions between authors and the timelines don't match up. And some of the things that are written about, in fact, cannot be proven by real experience in today's world, for they've long gone to dust in the annals of history. But we nonetheless must take these words seriously, and we must be intuitive in our own right, so that we might get the message that our Lord Jesus was intending to give his disciples, and thereafter to us here today. So we pray when we attend Holy Mass that we will be sincere in our learning, our focus on the sacrament itself, and on the words that were spoken to the apostles by Jesus and all the prophets. God love you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let's take this opportunity now to proclaim our faith. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father. He is God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered, died, and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in fulfillment of the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sin. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. May the mystery of the mingling of this water and wine help us to become one with Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Lord God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Wash my hands among the innocent and encompass your altar, O Lord, that I might hear the voice of your praise and tell of all your wondrous works. I've loved, O Lord, the beauty of your house, the place where your glory dwells. Take not away my soul, O God, with the wicked, or my life with men of blood, in whose hands are iniquities and filled with gifts. But as for me, I have walked in my innocence. Redeem me and have mercy on me. In the churches I will bless you, O Lord. Lord, wash away my iniquities and cleanse me of my guilt. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and that of all his church. Lord God, we pray that you receive these gifts from your church. May the great joy you give us come to perfection in heaven. Grant this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give him thanks and praise. Father, all-powerful and ever-living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks through Jesus Christ our Lord. We praise you with greater joy than ever in this Easter season when Christ became our paschal sacrifice. He is still our priest, our advocate who always pleads our cause. Christ is the victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain who lives forever. The joy of the resurrection renews the whole world, while choirs of angels in heaven sing forever to your glory. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power, God of might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest. Father, we acknowledge your greatness. All your actions show your wisdom and love. You formed us in your own likeness and set us over the whole world to serve you, our Creator, and rule over all creatures. Even when we disobeyed you and lost your friendship, you did not abandon us to the power of death, but helped us all to seek and find you. Again and again, you offered us a covenant and, through the prophets, taught us to hope for salvation. Father, you so loved the world that in the fullness of time, you sent your only Son to be our Savior. He was conceived through the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary, a man like us in all things but sin. To the poor, he proclaimed the good news of salvation, to prisoners, freedom, and to those in sorrow, joy. In fulfillment of your will, he gave himself up to death. But by rising from the dead, he destroyed death and restored life. And that we might live no longer for ourselves, but for him, he sent the Holy Spirit from you, Father, as his first gift to those who believe, to complete his work on earth and bring us the fullness of grace. Father, may this Holy Spirit sanctify these offerings. Let them become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, as we celebrate the great mystery which he has left us as an everlasting covenant. He always loved those who were his own in this world, and when the time came for him to be glorified by you as Heavenly Father, he showed the depth of his love. While they were at supper, he took bread into his sacred hands, and looking up to you as Heavenly Father, he gave you thanks and praise. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, he took the cup filled with wine. Again, he gave you thanks and praise, gave the cup to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Dying, you destroyed our death. Rising, you restored our life. Lord Jesus, come in glory. Father, we now celebrate this memorial of our redemption. We recall Christ's death, his descent among the dead, his resurrection, and his ascension to your right hand. And looking forward to his coming in glory, we offer you his body and blood, the acceptable sacrifice which brings salvation to the whole world. Lord, look upon this sacrifice you have given to your church, and by your Holy Spirit, gather all who share this one bread and one cup into the one mystical body of Christ, a living sacrifice of praise. Lord, remember those for whom we offer this sacrifice, especially our religious leaders and patriarchs. Joris, our patriarch in Utrecht, Francis, Bishop of Rome, for me, your humble servant, and for bishops and clergy everywhere. Remember those who take part in this offering, all your people, and all who seek you with a sincere heart. Remember those who have died in the peace of Christ, and all the dead whose faith is known to you alone. Father, in your mercy, grant also to us, your children, to enter into our heavenly inheritance in the company of the Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and your apostles and saints. Then in your kingdom, freed from the corruption of sin and death, we shall sing your glory with every creature through Christ our Lord, through whom you give us everything that is good. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. Well, wherever you are, join hands now and let us pray to the Father in the words our Savior gave us. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and sheltered from all needless anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but the faith of our church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. May the mingling of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to those who receive it. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, by the will of the Father and the work of the Holy Spirit, your death brought life to the world. By your holy body and blood, free me from all my sins and every evil. Keep me faithful to your teaching, and never let me be parted from you. This is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Corpus Domini nostri Jesu Christi, custodiet anima meam, in vitam aeternam. Amen. Sanguis Domini nostri Jesu Christi custodiet anima meam, in vitam aeternam. Amen.
once he walked beside me, like he'd been there all along. Not a stranger, but a father who can sense when something's wrong. And he answered all my questions, and he understood my fears that somehow vanished now that he was here. Can't you see who walks with you? Can't you hear who speaks your name? Can't you feel something stirring?
Christ had to suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day. In his name, penance for the remission of sins is to be preached to all nations Alleluia. Let us pray. Lord, look on your people with kindness, and by these Easter mysteries, bring us to the glory of the resurrection. We ask this in the name of Jesus the Lord. The Lord be with you. Bow your heads now and pray for God's blessing. Lord, bless us with your heavenly gifts, and in your mercy make us your obedient servants. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. May Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our Eucharistic celebration is ended for today. Let us go forth from this place to serve the Lord and one another. Alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia. On a personal note, I'll be absent from this altar for several weeks as I undergo heart surgery tomorrow, and I'm not sure quite how that will affect me or how long I'll be incapacitated, but as soon as I'm able to come back, I'll resume saying the Mass. God love you all. Let's join together in our closing hymn. Alleluia, sing to Jesus. Alleluia, sing to Jesus. His the scepter, His the throne. Alleluia, His the triumph, His the victory alone. Hark the songs of peaceful Zion, thunder like a mighty flood. Jesus out of every nation has redeemed us by His blood. Alleluia, King eternal, Thee the Lord of lords we own. Alleluia, born of Mary, earth thy footstool, heaven thy throne. Thou within the veil hast entered, robed in flesh, our great high priest. Thou on earth both priest and victim, in thy Eucharistic feast. God love you all. Thank you for joining us today.